To achieve our Paris Agreement target to limit the Earth's temperature rise to well below 2 degrees will require energy and industrial systems to be zero carbon by mid-century. The report that we've issued today indicates that there are clear pathways that will enable us to do that. And it's not a choice. I would say we must do this. The cost of doing so is very reasonable. It's less than 1% of GDP over time, and it's very much within our reach to achieve those targets. The cost of inaction far outweighs the cost of doing something now. The rapid expansion of zero carbon electricity will be the foundation upon which a zero carbon economy is built. Today, electricity is about 20% of final energy demand, and it needs to rise to about 60% by mid-century. It will require significant increases in what I would call intermittent renewable power generation, so really wind and solar, and they may account for as much as 85% of the electricity system in 2050. Importantly, the other 15% needs to be provided by a source of energy that is dispatchable, that we can turn on and off when we would like to do so. And bioenergy can play a major role in delivering that type of power. At Drax, we are playing our role in the transition to net zero. We've actually converted what once was Europe's largest coal-fired power station into what is now Europe's largest decarbonization project. And we stand ready to do more. Our groundbreaking bioenergy with CCS has the potential to deliver negative emissions, fulfilling a role that the report believes is critical for carbon capture. My vision is for Drax to enable a zero carbon, lower cost energy future for all. And if our low carbon electricity can help support the decarbonization of these hard to abate sectors that are described in this report, we think we have a major role to play.